You're watching WPBF 25 News at 6.
For our children, playing a sport is a great way to exercise, learn about teamwork, and develop discipline.
But as Tiffany Kenny shows us, sometimes that healthy competition can become unhealthy when kids focus on one sport for too long.
Now there are new recommendations urging parents to limit how often their kids play one sport.
When was the last time you guys threw a lacrosse ball?
Last season.
Last ACL tear.
Mari Tompkins loves lacrosse.
Quick passes.
The high school senior has been playing since seventh grade.
I like the group dynamic that I have with my teammates, but it's also a very singular sport in the case that you are holding the ball and you are running. I love having the camaraderie that I have with my teammates. Do I hear Melanie?
Yeah, I hear Mark.
But in March, Mari suffered a major injury.
I was running on the lacrosse field during a practice, hit a divot in the ground and heard a loud popping noise and fell to the ground and tore my ACL and partially tore my meniscus.
In the lower extremities, certainly ACL tears is one of the top injuries that we see.
Mari's orthopedic surgeon, Boca Raton doctor Jonathan Hersch, says injuries among young athletes like Mari are on the rise.
It's a combination of specialization and meaning playing one sport at a very young age and all year round. Florida, we're unique in that we have a temperature that allows to play outside sports all year round. So that combination here makes it even worse.
Hersch says in his own practice, he has seen more and more kids who focus on one sport with what's called overuse injuries.
So kids who are specializing, let's say, saying I'm a soccer player only at age 12, is not getting a rest from that sport. They're not necessarily using muscles and joints that maybe another sport would use and giving the lower extremities, legs, a rest.
So there's never really a break for the muscles.
Correct. There's no off season, and you have these kids playing regular seasons, travel sports, then they're doing showcases.
Mari also plays golf and for 7 years played tennis every day for 3 to 4 hours. But overuse injuries with her wrist and shoulder ended her budding tennis career.
If it's a sport you have to play often, I think you have to take the necessary breaks that you need and keep your body well.
And that's the message just issued by the National Athletic Trainers Association, who last month came out with new recommendations, urging parents to postpone their children specializing in one sport as long as possible, take 2 days off each week for rest, and not play a single sport for more than 8 months a year.
There has to be a season end in something, and you can play another sport. It doesn't mean you can't play sports all year round, but football goes into basketball, can go into lacrosse. They are different skills, they are different body parts moving.
So parents, here's a really good proposed rule of thumb if you're wondering just what's too much. A child's age should equal the number of hours he or she spends in sports training each week. For example, if your child is 12, he or she should not participate in more than 12 hours per week of an organized sport. Felicia and Todd?
All right, Tiff, thank you.